Five boys from the far north are on their way to South Africa to compete at one of the world's most prestigious rugby festivals. One determined mum made it happen after their school at first didn't make the cut. Helen Castles explains.
Opportunity is hard to come by if you play rugby in the far north.
These boys are trying to make it from up here without moving away, so you've just got to create opportunities. If they're not there, you've got to make it happen.
These Awanui players are good. They're Northland reps and are in the Blues junior development squad. So when Perrin Christy Hilton-Jones heard about the World Rugby School Festival in Cape Town, she wanted a piece of that for her boys.
They weren't in one of the top teams in New Zealand, so it was a bit of a long shot, but I just thought I'll email them.
The organisers listened and sent a representative north to check them out.
I can see that they've got a bit of edge on them, from kids not given opportunities up north. You can sense that they want to get into this competition and dominate.
We thought she was going to put the idea forward, but it wouldn't get much momentum, if any. But then to find out it was all go, and that like really made it feel real. So now we're just trying to work hard and make her proud because she's done all for us.
The boys will be part of a side that'll play two games against South African teams and receive world-class coaching, including from former Springbok coaches.
It's a world stage tournament. There'll be a lot of people watching it and TV and everything. And you never know, someone might get a career after this tournament.
There's already All Black genes in this team. Twins Ollie and Jamie's great uncle is the late Peter Hilton-Jones, who played 37 matches in the 1950s.
We've worked hard, we've trained hard, we're ready for it, and we're going to make sure we get ourselves exposed out there, get ourselves out there, get big, and yeah, that's the goal.
A goal now within their reach. Helen Castles, One News.